बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम गर्ल्स। टुडे वी हैव टू स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर एंड दिस इज़ आवर चैप्टर नंबर 7। चैप्टर नेम इज़ लिविंग इन आवर चेंजिंग वर्ल्ड, पेज नंबर 74 ऑफ आवर साइंस बुक 1। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल रीड अबाउट द चेंजेस इन मैटर दैट आर हैपनिंग ऑल अराउंड अस। And these changes may be physical change or the chemical change, and the factors that affect the changing of the matter are heat, light, electricity and the mixing. And we will read the changes that are caused by heat, light, mixing and electricity one by one. So let's move to the chapter explanation. As we are doing the reading and explanation of the chapter Living in Our Changing World, so in this chapter we will understand about the changes in the matter and the changes that are physical changes or it may be chemical changes, and the changes that are caused by heat, light, mixing and electricity. So first of all, I will tell you about the changes that are caused by heat. Before moving to the topic changes caused by heat, I will show you some diagrams in which you can see the changes in the matter. So in this diagram you can see the changes in the matter, as in the first one diagram, that is producing the mortar from the cement. When the cement is mixed with the water and the sand, then it converted into the mortar. Next one, the changes that is due to the charging a car battery. When we charge a car battery, it is a chemical change. And next one, and you can see the producing motor from the cement, it is a mixing, it is a change due to mixing. Next one, charging a car battery, it is a change in the matter due to electricity. Next one is taking a photograph, that is a change due to the light. And last one is the cooking food, that is a change due to heat. So first of all, I will tell you about the changes that are caused by heat. So the first one topic, that is about the changes caused by heat. Heat can produce many changes of the substance, as the heat can change the physical state of the matter. First one, the heat changes, it changes the physical state of matter. As you can take the example of ice, when you put the ice on your palm, then it melts, and it is due to heat, because your hand has a heat and the ice absorbs the heat from your hand and it melts. So it is a physical state change of physical state of the matter, as the ice converts into water. When the objects are heated, it expands. It means that when we put the objects on the heat, its volume increases, and when the volume increases, it means that the object expands. While in the opposite of expansion, there is a contraction, that is due to the low temperature. That means when the object cool down, then their volume decreases, and it means that the object contracts. And this expansion and contraction of the objects is different in solid, liquid and the gases. As we can take the example of the expansion, the expansion in the solid is less than the liquid, and in liquid it is less than to the gas. It means that gas has a more expansion at the same temperature at which there is a liquid and a solid. So next one, the change that is caused by heat is combination of two or more substances, that when we put two or more substances on the heat, they combine together. For example, when iron and sulfur, we put together on them and put on the heat, then they are converted into the new substance, iron sulfide. This is the second one change due to the heat, that is a combination of two or more substances. Third one change, that is the combustion or the burning. Combustion or the burning is the combination of the substance when oxygen with oxygen when it is heated. When we heat the object, then the substance is combined with the oxygen, like burning of the candle and the coal. When we burn the candle, then it combined with the oxygen and burn out, and it is also for the coal. And the last one change that is due to the heat is decomposition. Decomposition is the breakdown of the substances. And here we can take the example that when the sugar is heated, it decomposes into carbon and water vapors. It means that when the sugar is heated, it breaks down. Decompose means it breaks down into carbon and water vapors. Next one decomposition example is the calcium carbonate. When we heat the calcium carbonate, it also breaks down or decomposes in calcium and carbon dioxide. In the figure 7.1, page number 77, you can see the change of combination due to heat, that when we mix iron with the sulfur and we put it on heat, then it converted into iron sulfide, that is a new substance. And the next one, figure 7.2, shows the combustion due to heat. As you can see, the burning candle, that is an example of combustion. And in the figure 7.3, you can see the decomposition of the sugar. That shows that when the sugar is heated, it converted and it decomposed into carbon and water vapors. So this was our today's topic. You have to read the chapter till page number 78 and make 15 objective from these pages on a separate sheet of paper. Okay girls, Allah Hafiz.